Previously on Life is Strange Before the Storm.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
Hey, dickhead!
Get the fuck out of here!
Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
We don't have to like each other. But you will respect me.
Hello, Black Hal.
Chloe, do something!
Hey, do you know if Rachel is a gamer?
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Don't be surprised, Chloe. If one day I'm just out of here, let me know if you need an accomplice.
Damn, they are really going at it.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman? That was my dad. And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Miss Price, how good of you to join us.
I'm so sorry we're late. My shift ran late at the diner and then... just... sorry.
Let us proceed. One of you here is new to the Blackwell disciplinary process. And the other is all too familiar with it. Blackwell's code of conduct is built upon a foundation of mutual respect meant to foster an environment conducive to education and enrichment. When that respect
is
violated...
Okay, reality check time. Yesterday did actually happen. I ditched school with Rachel Amber, and then Rachel really did start that fire. And that was after we actually agreed to run away from here. Right?
Are you paying attention to me, Chloe?
What?
Miss Price, the last time we met, an agreement was brokered. Do you recall what that was?
Are you asking, or is that rhetorical?
Disrespectfulness. We agreed that you would rededicate yourself to becoming an exemplary Blackwell citizen.
We did?
In the event that you were unable or unwilling to do so, we also agreed that it would become pertinent to reassess your future status at the Academy. Despite all this, you engaged in the following actions yesterday. Insubordinate language. Attempting to sabotage the academic goals of one of our top students, Victoria Chase.
Academic goals like doing her own homework? Because I thought Blackwell had a zero tolerance policy on plagiarism.
Excellent suggestion. Stricter punishment for students who violate Blackwell's code of conduct is next on our agenda. For her plagiarism, Miss Chase might have been suspended.
Chloe, you tried to get someone suspended?
Might have. If Mr. Prescott, Nathan Prescott, hadn't spoken to me on Victoria's behalf, and we have witnesses saying Miss Price was also involved in a bullying incident of the same Mr. Prescott.
The hell I was. I stood up for that little weirdo.
Then how do you explain the desecration of Mr. Prescott's photography project?
I didn't say I was successful.
Oh, Chloe. Bullying?
Maybe you should be talking to Drew instead of me. You know, the guy who actually did what you're accusing me of.
Mr. North's situation requires sensitivity. It will be handled separately.
Mom, you know this is all bullshit, right?
Chloe, now is not the time.
Cut.
And yet, even with your prodigious disciplinary record, Miss Price, we needn't discuss any of it.
We needn't?
No, because you severed your relationship with Blackwell the minute you left school grounds without permission.
What does that mean?
It means... you forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe. I have no choice but to...
I made her do it.
What?
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 Yesterday was all me. My idea. I was having a bad day. I needed to blow off some steam, and I took it too far.
Chloe tried to talk me out of it. I've been down that road, she told me. You're better than this. But I wouldn't listen. See, Chloe was afraid I'd get in trouble or hurt, so she came with me. But only to keep me safe. I'm just sorry you got caught up in it, Chloe. That you allowed me to drag you down to my level. Can you forgive me?
Yeah, sure. We're cool.
Thank you. I'll make it up to you. I promise.
Chloe, is this true?
It's true.
Totally not true. She really is an amazing actress.
Miss Price?
Fine, yes. It was her idea, but it's not like she kidnapped me. We were in it together.
Miss Amber, based on what you've just told me, I have grounds to punish you. Are you sure what you've told me is the truth?
Yes.
This can't be the full story, Rachel.
Ray!
Just to be clear, Miss Amber, you're sure Chloe Price didn't coerce you or...
trick her?
Yes, I'm sure.
Oh, thank God.
Mrs. Price, this revelation may color the situation some, but it in no way absolves your daughter.
I understand, Mr. Wells. There is no doubt that Chloe's behavior must improve. But given what we've just learned about the negative influence she was under, I hope you will allow her just one more chance.
Miss Amber, I am as surprised as I am disappointed in you.
I understand.
This being your first infraction in no way reduces its severity. Still, we will not be suspending you at this time. But you have squandered our trust. You will no longer be my administrative assistant first period. And you will no longer be involved in Blackwell's performance of The Tempest.
No.
What? Are you insane?
Your discipline is still pending, Miss Price.
Ray, she loves that show. Since this is her first infraction,
Mr.
don't you
Amber,
think,
I don't tell you how to run the district attorney's office. Please, don't tell me how to run my school. There's a reason we have understudies for all circumstances, accidental and deliberate. I'm sure your understudy...
Victoria Chase.
How fitting. Yes, I'm sure Victoria Chase will do fine.
That is such...
What was that, Miss Price?
Chloe is upset for her friend, but we are both grateful that she is not going to be unduly blamed for what happened.
There is plenty of blame to go around. Chloe's future at Blackwell will be discussed next, unless you had something to add first, Miss Price.
No way is Rachel missing the play for me. But thanks to her acting skills, I'll have to go down in flames if I want to fix this.
Get your head out of your ass, Wells.
Chloe!
You seriously think yesterday was Little Miss Sunshine's idea?
Miss Amber has accepted her responsibility.
You're punishing her for taking the blame for me? For trying to be a good person? That makes you even more clueless than I thought.
Rachel confessed. Are you calling her a liar?
Wells, you should confess to falling for her crap. I don't blame you, though. She's one hell of an actress.
You don't have to do this. It's okay.
Really. How about you don't take credit for my shit? You don't see me claiming I did my homework, do you? Because that's your stupid thing.
Chloe, this can't be you. Apologize this instant.
Fine. I shouldn't have pulled Rachel out of class. If I'd known she couldn't handle it, I would have gone it alone.
Why speak up, Miss Price? Your words do not exonerate Rachel, but they do further implicate you.
Why? To tell the truth, for once. Something that happens so rarely around here. Everybody lies.
I've heard enough. Rachel, you were clearly trying to cover for your classmate. I appreciate the motive, but I appreciate honesty more. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
You will not be removed from the play.
Was that so hard?
Thank you.
And Miss Price, I came into today's meeting planning to suspend you for the rest of the school year, with a chance for reinstatement in the fall.
And now?
You are expelled.
What? No.
I will have Skip Matthews escort you to clean out your locker. You may wait outside my office until he arrives. That is all. Good day, Mrs. Price, Mr. and Mrs. Amber.
Ray.
Come on, Chloe.
I'm sorry.
Nothing to be sorry about. Meet me at the junkyard later?
You bet.
I didn't get the chance to introduce myself. I'm Joyce.
Mrs. Price.
I'm Rose. This is James. I'm sorry we had to meet like this.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sure for you this is an unusual circumstance.
We really should be going. Nice to meet you.
Mom, I'm...
I'll see you in the parking lot.
Hey, Chloe. I'm supposed to walk you out.
Just you and me. Hey, Skip?
Fuck 'em. Bunch of fascists. Hey, just wanted to say, it sucks what is happening to you.
Thanks, Skip.
You're gonna be missed.
I don't really care about any of this shit. Except my secret stash. Might as well grab my emergency joint while I'm here. I had big plans for adding to this collage. Oh well. Having Justin as my locker neighbor was one of the few not shitty things about this place. Trusty keeper of my graffiti pens.
You've served me well. Jackpot. Wait. What the hell? Damn it, Justin. Fuck every inch of this place. I wish I could tag it from floor to ceiling. But with Skip watching me...
Bathroom. Then I'm out. Cool?
Okay. But try to make it fast, will you?
Later, Skip.
Later.
Looks like David's here. Awesome. Max would have loved this shit.
Taking pride in Blackwell Athletics means taking pride in yourself. Also, the trustees and their enormous bank accounts.
At least I'll have, plenty of free time to take up skateboarding again. If I feel like it.
It's about damn time.
David, please.
Chloe, your mother and I have been talking.
I don't care.
I know. That's what we need to talk about.
I don't need a conversation. Not with Sergeant Asshat here. I just need some space.
Do not use that language with your mother.
If my mother has something to say, she will say it to me.
She has. The problem is, you don't listen. Maybe if you try listening to me, instead of fighting me about everything, you might actually learn a thing or two.
What? How to be a soldier?
Soldiers put family and future above self and now. Getting kicked out of school? That's what losers do.
You had a scholarship, Chloe. Do you know what that means? What kind of opportunity you gave up? Do you want to work at the diner?
There's nothing wrong with waiting tables, Mom.
Chloe, I'm proud to wait tables because it means you can be whatever you want to be. But what is that, Chloe? What do you want?
Maybe... I don't know yet.
Maybe you've had long enough to figure it out. Right now, what I need most of all is for the two of you to start getting along.
Chloe, I care about Joyce very much. I'm willing to forgive you for the incident yesterday. If you improve your attitude going forward.
Incident? What incident?
I'll just say, we had a rather frank discussion. But with an apology, I'm willing to start over.
Sure. Reset button pressed.
I am glad to hear it. From now on, I will be assisting your mother in a few areas. Like making sure that you are no longer abusing drugs or alcohol.
Mom.
Chloe, I'd like you to empty your pockets and place all your belongings on the trunk of the car.
What the fuck?
If we are going to start over, we have to know that you are not abusing drugs. If you're not, you should be eager for the chance to prove it.
Mom, you can't be serious.
David and I have discussed it, and we feel this is the only way for us all to have a fresh start.
Let's go, Chloe. Quit stalling.
Fine. You want to see my shit so badly? You know what sucks even worse than invading someone's privacy? Doing it for no reason.
You're awfully smug for someone who just got kicked out of school.
Chloe, I'm sorry. Can you forgive me?
Sure. As long as you promise to never speak to this asshole again.
Chloe.
Joyce, you can't start apologizing now. This will only encourage her.
That's enough out of you, David. We need to start treating each other better. And that means all of us. We need a new beginning. A new chapter. One that will involve the three of us together.
Well, What does that mean?
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
No fucking way!
Chloe, after everything that's happened, I'm at a loss. I need help.
Exactly. We need a firmer hand steering this ship.
Talk to me, Chloe. Tell me what you're feeling.
You're trying. I get it. I swear, I do. And I've been making it harder for you. But this is not the answer.
It's the only answer I have, Chloe.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me. I'm sorry I took that for granted.
I'm not choosing anyone over anyone else. It's about the three of us having a home together.
It'll be better than you think, Chloe. Once everything's running smoothly, you'll see what a stable home can be like.
There is no home. Not if he's there.
Chloe.
Let her go. She'll come home as soon as her tantrum is over.
How do you know which way is up when your whole life has been turned upside down? Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left? This thing is a mess, but maybe I can fix it. If this beast will ever run again, the first thing it needs is a new battery. Wonder if I can find one around here.